Saturday morning, 6 a.m., 3 p.m., Sunday night. We're going to give you off Sunday morning to go to church. We won't do anything on Sunday morning ever if we can help it. Sunday night, 6 p.m., back in Chilling. Monday, 6 a.m., is the last session. So excluding Thursday's workout, we'll have weights tomorrow also. I'm sorry, we forgot weights tomorrow. The normal weight schedule will be on your calendar. And then Monday is the first session. So we have 9 sessions for boot camp.
Good morning. Good morning.
Get started.
Good morning.
Wait, anybody left down there? You three. You three the last one, right?
We usually start boot camp or any practice with zigzags. So, you know, we started off where we partner up and we do a variation of defensive slides.
You're trying to win. Okay? This isn't brother ball. Like this is no short, you know, and all are having fun. No. Try to beat. Put pressure to the defense. Put
pressure.
Back to normal. Then we run to catch up. When we get back there, it's back to normal. And you come slide, hand out, hit on the ball.
After the defensive slides, we break into groups of 2 at 8 stations. Stations consist of, you know, multiple defensive. I mean, it's all about mental toughness, testing, you know, how far we can push our bodies. We're at each station for about 1:25 with 15 seconds rest in between.
No, Joe! That's all you can do. The bottom of the freaking rim. That's it. I think I can do the bottom of the rim.
Boot camp is pretty much our main source of conditioning. Pretty much Coach Laird's basketball in a nutshell.
Sessions, we break it down into blue, red, liberty, and flames, and then a last one of champions, which is a team running. And basically what it is just, you know, see how much you can take running wise. I mean, Coach Laird is all about mental toughness, defense, and, you know, it's really the 2 biggest things that he stresses to our team. And boot camp is designed to, it basically lays the foundation for what Coach Laird stands on.
It's
physically grueling trying to get through this thing because, you know, you're working hard, you're sprinting, but at the same time, you got to, it's not just you, you're running for your team.
Hard work, dedication, get through it, struggle, everything, pain, fight, get through it together as a team. And top 10 hardest thing I've ever had to do in my life.
Defensive slides today. For some reason, my sneakers, the laces split, and it was coming undone. I mean, it's boot camp right here. That's what boot camp does. I mean, ain't nothing else to say. I mean, you work hard, it's what happens.
And I always dreamed about maybe playing for my dad one day, but it never really was real to me until this year, and last year even, thinking about it.
Get Ethan out! Stand over there and talk to somebody, Ethan! You gotta know what you're doing!
He's been tough on me, but not singling me out too much. He's been good so far. And it's kind of weird waking up in the morning, eating breakfast with the man that's about to go kill you in boot camp, but it's good. So far, adversity has hit us in boot camp. Today, probably the most, today and yesterday. When adversity hits, sometimes we get scrambled, chaotic. Everyone's trying to talk. But probably the biggest leader right now has been Jesse.
Y'all gotta be ready to go.
We're ready to go.
You gotta lead your group. Y'all gotta lead, one of y'all. You gotta carry your weight. You're going too slow.
No, he did. He ran his time, all right.
Whatever is happening between y'all two, y'all leaving him out to dry. All right. Pick it up.
Time to do jobs.
Cracks. Dave, you came in not ready today. You came in just to survive. That's a crack. Yesterday, Jesse didn't handle the loss very well. That's a crack. We didn't have any followers of people yesterday. That's a crack. We caved in to adversity. That's a crack. Our cracks will be exposed. They'll be exposed at Texas A&M. Don't you want to fill in the cracks today?
Yes, sir.
And not do it at Texas A&M?
Yes, sir.
That's what we're here for.
We just had, like, Jesse, our captain, stepped up, tried to get us together. I helped out. We had people that was following him, echoing what he was saying, and just getting us through it and getting the line set up. And then from there, we were good. We finished it. But that adversity definitely, like, when it hit, like, the first instant, we really didn't handle it well. There was a lot of yelling. There was a lot of start overs. It was just a lot of chaos. But through it all, like, we got through it, and we ended up, like, pursuing and getting past the adversity.
I should come second in the world championship. Right behind him, same. Oh, bro.
Maybe out there is a huge loss. As a point guard, I'm always looking around to who I can count on, who I can rely on when the going gets tough, whether it's, you know, in conference play, we need a bucket, we need a stop in a defensive drill, we need a rebound. You know, a dude like JB was someone who I could always count on. Right now, you know, I'm looking around, I got Shane, got Cabe, got Dave, a couple other guys. So in boot camp, not having them out there is a big loss. You know, having that guy, who, you know, probably the fastest dude on our team, making sure we can get a sprint. But emotionally, vocally, he's, you know, a leader just as much as he would be physically. So having him out there and encouraging guys is huge for our team. Having him counting out, you know, seconds on the clock, encourage person when he's down, he has a good balance of that. So he's still a big presence and a big leadership, plays a big leadership role on our team, whether he's out there or whether he's not.
Seeing the way he's handled his injury, really convicting to me. Makes me wonder if I'd be able to handle it as well as he has. A great teammate, but he's pretty close to irreplaceable on the court.
There you go. Just make the adjustments on the fly, fellas. Come on.
Good job, Tommy.
There you go. Good job, Tommy. Way to sell out, Tommy. Way to sell out, Tommy.
Although he's not playing on the floor, like, he still is our captain. Like.
Way to hold your own.
towel drill. It's like you're on all fours with a towel on your hands, and you're moving it with your, you're pushing it forward, and then you using your feet to drive you forward. And like that was a killer. Like it's crazy on your thighs, and you're going back down and back, and it's just tough.
I think what boot camp means to Coach Layer is really based in the toughness of the team. I think who Coach Layer is as a coach and who he wants our team to exemplify is the toughest team on the court, regardless of who we're playing. So in his mind, and what he's portrayed to me, is that we're going to get through this boot camp. This is going to be the hardest thing we're going to do all season, and we're going to reach back to this in the future. So when we go to A&M, we say, okay, we can play A&M. We got through boot camp. We're in the conference championship. Okay, we can play Asheville in the championship. We've been through boot camp. So this is...
Man, let's go, man.
Gotta go, Drew.
He's pushing us to the limit so that, yes, it's going to stretch us, push us, but then once we've done it, we're going to have that pride and that sense of accomplishment. So I think that's what boot camp is a extremely high mark or high bar for the team and for individuals to, yes, stretch, push, get in shape, you know, build your endurance up, all that's good, but it's as mental as much as it is physical, something that we can reach back on and draw strength, knowing that we've done something as a team.
This is how we are. That's what we are at Liberty, so tough things, we just get through it.